Hi, this is Dr. Carl Leopsen at the University of Arizona, Associate Professor, and I'm going to show you how to calculate or describe the level of data within a phase and between phases in a single subject research study, and how to calculate data overlap using the percentage of non-overlapping data formula. We're going to be using a study from the Journal of Applied Behavior Analysis, 1998, Treatment of Sleep Problems in a Toddler, a replication of the Faded Bedtime with Response Cost Protocol by Rosemary Ashbaugh and Stephanie Peck. Let's come down to the graph. There are two things that you need to consider when you're determining level. You need to determine the level within any individual phase, and then because replication is what we're looking for in a single subject study, or change in level between phases and then replications, we need to determine the change in level between phases. Always keep in mind that you can't compare across phases. You can't jump from one phase to another. You can only compare adjacent phases. In this case, I know that the mean from reading the results section, and I could calculate it myself, but I'm going to believe them. For the baseline, here is 18. And generally, that's how level is described in any individual phase. So if you're talking about a single phase, you report the mean and the range of the data. I also know that the mean for the first intervention phase was 6. So if I was going to report on that individual phase, that first intervention phase, I'd give the mean and the range for that data. In comparing levels across these phases, I want to consider whether or not the level is an improving level in terms of the direction that's expected for the study, or whether it is a deteriorating level. And in this case, it's improving. It's moving in the direction that's either anticipated or expected by the researchers. Now let's talk about data overlap. When you first look at this study, you can see there is this change, this improving change in level. But you can also see there's not a lot of stability in this data, and we've looked at that in another video. So we want to consider how much of an overlap is there between the data points across phases. To do that, there are lots of different ways to do that, actually. But one of the most common ways is the percentage of non-overlapping data model. And the way you would do that is really pretty simple. First, you figure out the range of the data in the preceding phase, the prior phase, and that is from this low point of 8 up to probably 31 here. So what you can see in this first intervention phase is that we have some data points that overlap with data in the baseline, when there was no treatment in place, no intervention. And the way we get a number on that is to count up the number of data points that are outside of this range and baseline. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we have 8 data points overall. Let's grab our calculator. see that we've got 6 divided by 8 times 100. Not bad. 75% of the data in the intervention phase falls outside the range of the baseline data, or the data from the preceding phase. You can eyeball this for the next two phases. Let's take another look at it. We can tell pretty quickly what the answer is going to be when we set up the range for this intervention phase and look at the return to baseline. I'd say we've got 100% of the data points that fall outside of the range from the prior phase. The same thing if you were going to take a look at the range from the baseline. There are no data points from the final intervention phase that fall within this range of the second baseline. And when you report the percentage of non-overlapping data, it's reported as just that, a percentage, and folks who are reading your study can make their own determination of how much overlap is all right and expected.